guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if this is the first video of mine that you're seeing. For today's video, I'm going to be doing a get ready with me for Valentine's Day 2021. If you haven't seen my what I got for Christmas, then you won't know that I got the James Charles Morphe palette. And in all honesty, when I saw one of the shades in there, I instantly wanted to do a Valentine's Day makeup look. It's a really, really pretty pink colour, and I thought I'd include it for a video because I really, really love the colour. And I love pink, it's my favourite colour. If you want to see how I achieve this makeup look, then go ahead and keep on watching. So, I think I'm going to start off with my eyes, just because if there's any fallout, then I don't want it to go onto the foundation. I'm going to be using a mixture of this palette, the James Charles palette. To prep my eyes for the makeup, I'm just going to be taking some concealer and some powder and then just patting that onto my eyelid. I'm going to be doing one eye on camera and then I'll do the other one off camera just to save a little bit of time. You can hear noise outside as well, it's like builders and stuff, sorry. Like I said, I'm just going to be using some powder, setting that just so that it doesn't crease. Taking just this colour from the Naked Urban Decay 3 palette, I'm just going to put that all over my lid. Can't really see that at all, it's a really subtle colour. It's basically on the lid just to be the base colour. Out from Naked Urban Decay, the Cherry palette, using the colour Feels and just putting that in the outer third and blending it into the crease. This palette is really pigmented, which is why I decided to do my eyes first as well. From the same palette, taking Young Love, which is this colour just here, and putting that into my crease as well. So that's what we have so far. Now, to get the pop of colour that I really want, we're taking the James Charles Morphe palette. At the bottom, there's these three pinks. I think that one's a bit more purpley, but these two are really, really pretty. This colour here is what instantly caught my eye. I was like, I need to film something with that colour, so that is going to be going on the inner corner. I'm also going to just drag it by where this line here is. I'm then going to be taking the Naked Cherry palette again, thing which is just this colour, putting that to my crease. We have so far. It'll look better when all my makeup is on. I feel like it all just looks like one colour at the moment. It's really messy right now, but I promise it'll look better. You've just got to trust the process. The first eye done. I'll obviously put mascara and bottom lower lash line eyeshadow on. That's the first eye. I'm going to go ahead and do this one off camera and then I will be back. This is the other eye done. I'm aware it looks very crazy right now. I'm now going to get started with the face makeup. For foundation, I have actually changed the product. I was using the Estee Lauder Double Wear foundation. Tan is now gone because I stopped fake tanning. And that's the foundation that I use on tan. So I have gone to my original foundation that I had before I was tanning. And as always, I'm gonna just be blending it in with a beauty blender. This one is so dirty, excuse that. A few. I pull the weirdest faces when I do my makeup, that for me. So that is a finished look. I really hope you guys enjoyed. I feel like I do my blending in really aggressively. Now that is all blended in and I look like a ghost, I am going to be setting it with the same powder, the number 7 powder. I face is all powdered. I'm gonna go ahead and take my bronzer. This is just the Bobbi Brown one that I always use, and I'm just gonna be adding some warmth back into my face. But I don't think it really makes much difference. I'm gonna go ahead and do the color underneath my eyes just to stop them from looking so crazy. Get the color feels again. And just put this underneath my eyelash line. There we go. It was a lot crazier than I expected it to be. I really didn't know what I was gonna do for this look. Hopefully with lashes and mascara it'll look better. Blush, I'm going to be taking the same blush that I always use. It's just the MAC in this shade Gentle. It just looks like this. I just sellotape it because the lid broke. I'm just going to be using the same blush brush that I always use. And then with blush, if you know me, I put blush everywhere. And then with forehead, cheeks, eyes. Pretty sure you're not really meant to do this, but I will. I always add too much as well. For my eyebrows, I'm of course going to be using the REFY by Jess Hunt Eyebrow Kit. I'm going to just be taking this normal one from number 7 and just brushing up my brows. Using the pomade, which is the one where it's got the bit at the end where you dip it into. I'm just going to lightly fill in my eyebrows. I hate going too crazy because I feel like because my eyebrows aren't that thick at all, it looks kind of crazy if I go too crazy. I just kind of fill in the front bit. And then any bits at the end that look a bit sparse. Just very, very lightly. Don't go too crazy, that's pretty much all I do. Tip it in again, same on the other eye. Pretty much all I do, and I'm just gonna set them. I'm not really a pro when it comes to doing my eyebrows. I've never really, like, for the rest of my face, I feel like I know what I like and I know what suits me, but for my eyebrows, I've never ever known what to do with them. Just don't know. So that's just all I pretty much do to them. Set them, I'm using the REFY, that's upside down, the REFY Sculpt. This is really, really nice to set your brows in place. And that's literally all I do to them. So going back into the James Charles palette, I'm just going to be taking this gold shade here, highlighting my brow bone with that. Okay, that is pretty much it all done. I'm going to go ahead and do mascara and my fake eyelashes. I'll list all the products that I use down below. I'm going to go ahead and do that off camera just because I find it quite difficult to film that. And then I will be back to show you the lips, my hair, what I'm going to do with my hair, and then my outfit and my jewellery. I don't know why I did that. Never even said which mascara I was using. I'm using the Volume Million Lashes. So mascara and lashes are now on. I feel like the lashes have made the look a lot better. I feel like this was definitely a trust the process kind of look. So for lips, I'm just going to be using the Max Factor Lip Gloss. This is just a pink colour. I feel like because the eyes are so bold, I didn't want to go for red or anything. I just wanted to go for a really simple one. Makeup. That is the makeup. I'm gonna go ahead and do my hair and then get my outfit on, and then I will be back to show you what that looks like. For my hair, I've just gotten dressed. So for my hair, I usually just leave it like this. It's just plaited. I do this with my hair every single day. It gets kind of boring, but it stops me from using heat on it, and it's just really, really quick and easy. Just usually keep one bit of my hair on this side where my shoulder is. Then I've got this necklace that Max got me for 1 year. And then just random earrings because I left my earrings at his place. that is it for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. This was my take on my Valentine's Day 2021 makeup look. It is quite a bold look, so if you were wanting to do something a bit simpler, then you can obviously just tone down the colours and not put so much on your lid or in your crease or whatever. That is it for this video. I hope you guys have a lovely Valentine's Day, whatever you're doing, whoever you're celebrating it with. I think that's all I have to say for this video. I will leave all the products that I've used down below, and I'll list the colours that I put on my eyes when I edit this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye! Before I end this video, I also just wanted to show the present that my sister got me. I'm aware that we're in the middle of February now. Obviously, Christmas was about 2 months ago, so we weren't able to see each other on the day. She actually just gave me the presents yesterday. She got me the Revolution Friends crossover mug. It's the Central Perk one. It's all Friends related, shocker. And inside it just has these really, really pretty contour colours, and then a mirror that's a mug. I thought that was so cute. The next thing that she got me were some Friends socks. I'm wearing them right now, so I'll put a picture here just so that you can see them. Again, Friends related, obviously because it was Christmas related, but she got me this ornament that you stick on a tree, and it's the turkey from Friends where Monica dresses up as it. I'll put a picture there. Just thought I'd include that because I know that I've already filmed what I got for Christmas because I didn't want to be filming it now in February, but I did just want to say thank you to my sister for getting those for me.